process modeling, PFDs, flow charts, data modeling, DR diagrams, data dictionaries, structured analysis techniques by Christian Fabio Pura. So, process modeling, DFDs, flow chart. Process modeling is the graphical representation of business processes or workflows. Like flow chart, individual steps of the process are drawn out so there is an end-to-end overview of the task in the process within the context of the business environment. So, sa process modeling ay, ito yung mga kailangan natin sa ano, sa capstone proposal, like mga flow chart, mga DFDs. Ito yung proseso kung saan nagbibigay daan sa visualization ng process ng business katulad ng mga organization upang malaman ng pamamaraan ng sagayoy kanilang ma-manage at magawa efficiently. Minsan tinatawag din itong agile kasi mas continuous improvement. Dito, kailangan mo ng process modeling ng sagayoy matukoy ang mga gawain para malaman din yung kailangan idagdag at itugma sa pinaplano ng naaayon din sa ginawang model. So, without process modeling to guide them, these organizations are flying blind. Di nila makikita ang process of paano ma-optimize yung workflow. Like katulad nga netong example natin. We have an example of process modeling, which is ordering system. So, itong process modeling ay tinatawag din natin na business process modeling, which allows the different stakeholders to visualize business process and how to make workflows. So, katgaya niyan, meron tayong create purchase order and approve purchase order, which is ito ay isang activity. Itong activity na to ay nag-create purchase order at approve purchase order ay tinatawag na activities na nag-i-illustrate ng specific task performed by person or system sa process na to na create purchase at approve. Dito nagaganap at nagkakaroon ng transaction which is involved ang payment process. So, dito naman sa diamond symbol, which is ang tawag ay gateways. Itong diamond symbols ay tinutukoy nito yung direction ng process, which will turn next para sa next process. Ito naman mga arrow right ay tinatawag na sequential flow. Itong mga arrow ay nire-represent ay sequential flow of objects na kung tawagin ay sequence. Kumbaga, dyan para sa next process. Itong mga circular symbols ay representation ng starting point, intermediate step, o end point ng particular process. So, ano nga ba mga benefits ng using process modeling? So, what are the benefits of using process modeling? Improve efficiency. Process modeling helps to improve the process, helping business workers to be more productive by saving time. So, sa improve niya ay magiging efficient at recognizable sa mga organization kung help well-planned at gagamitan ng process modeling, it will cost less time consumed. So, sa gain transparency, modeling provides a clear overview of the process, identifying the start and end point and all the steps in between. Sa gain, makikita ang pinaka-output na detailed at informative para sa organization kagaya na pagkakaroon ng diagram na may starting point at end point, yung pinaka-workflow niya. So, ensure best practice. Using process models ensures consistency and standardization across the organization. So, less worries of reiteration of a model for the system. Kung may consistency and standardization, dito din ang workflow ng process magaganap, which include yun din yung testing phase, susubukan kung gaano ka-efficient yung work. So, create understanding by using the common language of process, it makes it easier for users across the organization to communicate with each other. Dito yung requisition phase na kung ano yung mga requirement ng stakeholders na needs at ano yung mga specific tasks na dapat i-include dito sa ating process o ang ating model. So, business orchestration supports the coordination of people, systems, and information across the organization to support business strategy. So, business orchestration presents the objectives, structure, scope with the help of guidance of those organizations. So, flowchart. A flowchart is a type of diagram that represents a workflow or process. A flowchart can also be defined as a diagrammatic representation of an algorithm, a step-by-step approach to solving a task. The flowchart shows the steps as boxes of various kinds and their order by connecting the boxes with the arrows. This diagrammatic representation illustrates a solution model to a given problem. Flowcharts are using analyzing, designing, documenting, or managing process or program in various fields. Bakit kailangan ng flowchart? To develop understanding of how process is done, para pag-aralan ng proseso ng improvement, to communicate and gain recommendations from others how process is done, to document the process before implementation phase. So para ito yung magiging graphical representation niya sa document para mabuo yung system. Like at tulad nga ng ginagawa natin sa Capstone 2. Capstone. So, we have the symbol. Ang pinakauna natin ay start-end. An oval represents a start or end point. So, tinatawag din itong terminator symbol, which represents the starting and end point, the beginning or end of the workflow. So, we have arrows. A line is a connector that shows relationship between the representative shapes. It indicates that information is required at the stage of workflow process. We have input and output. A parallelogram represents input or output. So, it represents the action o function, kagaya nga ng action na ginawa natin sa process previously, na may purchase order or like book flight, so and so on and so forth. Yun ang action sa process. Decision. A diamond indicates sa decision. Ito yung tumutukoy sa next process ng workflow from the word decision itself. Siya yung nagde-decide ng next steps which proceeds to the next process. We have the flowchart symbols, like katulad niyan, process, input, like what I said, let process, input, document, alternate process, terminal, predefined process, multi-document, data, decision, database, delay, merge, preparation, manual input, manual operation, on-page reference, off-page reference. So, data flow diagram. Dito naman tayo sa data flow. A data flow diagram is a way of representing a flow of data through a process or system, usually an information system. The DFD also provides information about the outputs and inputs of each entity and the process itself. A data flow diagram has no control flow. There are no decision rules and no loops. Specific operations based on the data can be represented by a flowchart. So, ang DFD ay nagpo-provide ng straightforward, efficient way sa mga organization to understand, perfect, and implement new process or systems. Ito ay ang visual representation of process or system. So, they make it easy to understand as any professional business executive how they became successful, and it all because they mastered a process sa pamamagitan nga ng tinatawag nating DFD, data flow diagram. Like katulad nga ng sa system proposal natin, bago ang implementation developmental stages ay kailangan sa documentation may workflow ng process para mas maayos yung system. Ito, mga symbols ng data flow diagram. Katulad niyan, yung arrow ay show the flow of data into or out the process entity or data store. Yan ay tinatawag na data flow. Firstly, ito yung symbol na uses arrow na pwedeng papuntang right or left, up or down. So, what is the use of this data flow? It shows the flow of data into or out the process entity. or data stored. Basically, siya yung nagpapakita kung yung data ba ay palabas or paalis ng isang process, entity, or data store. So, we have the so-called process. Perform some action on the data such as create, modify, store, view, delete, and others. So, dito, it uses the symbol, yan, square. Like, ano nga ba ang gamit nitong process nito? It performs some action on the data such as create, modify, kagaya nga ng sabi ko, store, view, delete, and others. Kung titignan natin ang mga process natin ay are in verb form. Huwag natin kalimutan na when we are using process sa DFD, dapat verb ang malalagay din natin doon. Origin or destination of data ang tawag sa ating entity, external entity. Uses the symbol rectangle. So this entity shows the origin or destination of data. It is also called source sink. Bakit nga ba siya tinawag na source sink? Source kasi pwede siyang maging origin o source ng data. Sink pwede siyang mag-receive ng data. And lastly, it is where the data is stored. Data store. From the word data store itself, of course, dito po natin ini-store yung data. Data store uses this symbol. Rectangle na may open sa gilid. Like I said, it is where the data is being stored. So, ito yung mga rules natin sa data flow diagram. Before you start mapping out the data flow diagrams, you need to follow 4 best practices to create a valid DFT. Firstly, each process should have at least one input and one output. 2, each data store should have at least one data flow in the end data flow out. A system's stored data must go through a process. All processes in DFT must link to another process or data. We have the level 0 data flow diagram. This is the highest level, which provides an overview of the entire system. It shows the major processes, data flows, and data source in the system without providing any details about the internal workings of these processes. So dito yung kung tawagin ay yung pinaka single high level, pinapakita dito yung single high level ng process with its relationships to external entities. So like for example, we have the example for DFD 0 context level. So meron isang process which is itong student enrollment system. With 2 entities, which is itong registrar at itong student. Si registrar na maglalagay ng courses sa subject sa system, and these courses can be viewed by students. After makita ni students yung mga subjects na pwede niya i-enroll, ibibigay ng student yung info niya, i-input na nito sa system. Tapos si system magpo-provide ng list of enrolled students. So, this is a context diagram. Like katulad niyan, si registrar magbibigay ng courses subjects sa students. Si students magbibigay ng students info. Tapos si system magbibigay ng list enrolled students. Yan ang ating data flow diagram, context diagram. So, data flow diagram level 1. The context diagram is decomposed into multiple bubbles processes. In this level, we highlight the main functions of the system and break down the high level process of 0 level DFT. So, ayun, ang ating level 1, ito yung slightly detailed version ng level 0. Medyo detailed na siya kasi may mga processes na siya. Data flow diagram level 2 goes one step deeper into parts of level 1. DFD, it can be used to plan or record the specific necessary detail about the system's functioning. So, DFD level 2 slightly further detailing processes, it can relate to particular functions. Data modeling. Data modeling is the process of creating a simplified diagram of a software system and the data elements, and it contains using text and symbols to represent the data how it flows. Data models provide a blueprint for designing a new database or re-engineering a legacy application. So, sa data modeling, built around business needs, data can be modeled by at various levels of abstractions. Ang proseso na to ay nagsisimula sa pag-collect ng information about sa business requirements from stakeholders and end users. Then itong business rules ay translated into structures to formulate database design. Meron nga tayong mga example ng data modeling. Like katulad nitong ER diagrams. An entity relationship diagram, ERD, also known as an entity relationship model, is a graphical representation that depicts relationships among people, objects, places, concepts, or events within an information technology system. An ERD uses data modeling techniques that can help define business processes and serve as the foundation for a relational database. So, napaka-essential ng modeling. ER diagrams ay essential for modeling that is stored in database. Basically, ito yung pinaka-design para mabuo yung database. ER diagrams specify what data we will store and the entities and their attributes. They also show how entities relate to other entities. Like katulad nga ng sa capstone nga natin, may mga provision tayo na tinatawag para sa ER diagrams, like itong mga process modeling, data modeling, kailangan natin specify for us to plan the system. So, components of ER diagram. This model is based on the three basic concepts. Entities, attributes, relationships. Entity, a thing such as a house, object, concept, or event that can have data stored about it. Example, ito nga, a customer, student, car, or product, typically shown as a rectangle. Relationship, how entities act upon each other or are associated with each other. So, may communication tong relationship. For example, the name student might register for a course. The two entities would be the student and the course, and the relationship depicted is the act of enrolling, connecting the two entities in that way. Typically shown as diamonds or labels directly on the connecting lines. Attribute, a property or characteristic of an entity. Often shown as an oval or circle. Like katulad niyan, attribute. So, data dictionaries. Data dictionary is a collection of metadata such as object name, data type, size, classification, and relationship with other data assets. Think of it as a list along with a description of tables, fields, and columns. The primary goal of a data dictionary is to help data teams understand data assets. Data dictionary ay centralized na repository ng information about data such as meaning, relationships to other data, origin, usage, and format. And it assists management's database, administrations, systems analysis and application programmers in planning, controlling, evaluating the collection, storage, and use of data, and is used by data administrations, administrators, analysts, and engineers to understand and trust data assets. It helps the creation of authentic, transparent, and consistent data throughout the organization. Structured analysis techniques. Structured analytic techniques. Systematically reviewing hypotheses or options to gain insights for better understanding and presentation. Analysts face new challenges as the diversity of groups working common issues expands. Itong structured analysis ay isang developmental method that allows the analyst to understand the system and its activities in a logical way. A systematic approach which uses graphical tools that analyze and refine the objectives of an existing system and develop a new system. Specification which can be easily understandable by user. Itong method na to ay yung systematic development, which is the overall functionality of the system, tapos yung mga graphical activities. Done. Thank you po.